Hello, Pocoyo. Hello, Pa...
Sorry. Hello. What are you doing in that boat?
Fish.
Ah, I see. You're fishing.
Net.
You have a fishing net and a fishing rod. And Caterpillar is going to help. Wonderful. Now we just have to wait.
Professor Otto.
Now, class, pay attention. Professor Otto says, this is a ship. A ship. This is a boat. A boat. And this is a lighthouse. A lighthouse. Baby bird, can you tell us what that is? Can you tell baby bird what that is?
It's a lighthouse!
Hmm. It looks as if the angry alien has something he wants to say.
Lighthouse!
Wonderful! Now we know about ships, boats and lighthouses. Thank you, Professor Pato!
Lesson approved by Professor Pato.
Can you tell Caterpillar what that is?
Fish! It's a fish!
That's right, it's a fish. Can you tell the fish what that is? Can you tell the fish what that is?
A fishing rod!
It's a fishing rod!
Look, boys! Pato's got something!
Pato, Pato! Fish!
A boot?
Fish, Pato, fish!
A wheel? Fishing can be very hard. Number menu.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Ah. Time for a nice lunch. It looks like Pato is ready to order. 10 strawberries. Very good.
10 strawberries!
Oh dear. Well, how about 10 peas instead? Ten peas. Ah, poor Pato. Can you tell Pato how many hearts there are?
10 hearts!
That's right, 10. Oh dear, you're not catching many fish. Oh, it's a big one! A very big one. Now, Pato and Pocoyo, you're not really angry, are you? After all, it was pretty funny. Hooray for fishing! And hooray for new friends!
I'm in a boat, I am fishing with my fishing rod. To catch a fish, I am using my net. Fishing with my fishing rod. To catch a fish, I am using my net.
A Viking Adventure. Hello, Pocoyo. What are you reading? Is it a book about knights? Ah, it's a book about Vikings. I see you're a Viking swordmaster. But who are you fighting against? Against the Kraken? You're very good at fighting, Pocoyo, but to be a real Viking, you still need a helmet, a shield, and above all, a boat. That's much better.
Get the Kraken!
Excuse him, everyone. Pocoyo is a Viking, and he's very focused because he's going to face the fearful Kraken. But Pocoyo, what's the matter?
They're not Viking.
Now that's much better. The brave Vikings set out on an expedition. What do you have there, Pocoyo? Oh, of course, it's the map to find the Kraken. Uh-oh, it seems you have company. Everyone to their posts! Everyone be careful, they have you surrounded! Oh, thank goodness, it's just Baby Bird. It's okay, Pato, you're safe. Bye-bye, Baby Bird. Bye, Caterpillar. You're great sharks. Have you seen something, Pocoyo? Uh-oh. Pato, something strange is happening. Pato! Ah, you couldn't hear me through the helmet. I think there's something wrong with the others. Be careful, you're going too fast. Pato, are you okay? Sleepy Mermaid is the one singing. Of course. The mermaid melody has hypnotized Pocoyo and Ellie.
Whip it.
good, Pato. You saved us. Oh, no. Sleepy Mermaid has woken up again. Very good, guys. You made it just in time. But have you noticed that you're flying?
Balloons?
Where did those balloons come from? Just a moment. What was that? Ah, Baby Bird and Caterpillar helped you. Careful! You crashed into something. Guys, what are those bubbles? Oh, the Kraken! Careful, Ellie. What? Oh, no. Now you've really made him mad.
I know.
Of course. What a great idea. Music calms down Krakens. What groovy Vikings. Hooray for music and adventures with friends. See you next time. The Treasure Hunt. Hello, Pocoyo.
No, hello. Arr.
Oh, you seem to be a real pirate. I'm afraid you're not the only pirate plying these waters. It's Red Feather Pato. Hello, Ellie. I mean, Captain Ellie. Oh, it has a message. Is it a letter? Or a parchment? Or a pirate shopping list? A map!
Map! Treasure! Find!
Pirate Pocoyo, show us the way!
You can't read the map, can you? Great idea, Cap'n Ellie. The first thing to do is to find which way is north. Okay, that's better.
Pirates, let's get the chest.
Finally, we found it!
Treasure!
Ooh, what is it? Show it! Show it! Another map? What a great treasure! And look, it says there is another chest hidden at the bottom of the sea!
Yay!
Diving pirates, let the search continue! Quick! Let's open the... Oh, dear.
Oh,
is ours.
Hooray for this pirate victory!
Another map?
And it says there are many more chests to discover. Fabulous!
You're right, Ellie. Now, how do we leave the seabed?
Oh, hello, whale. Listen, do you know how we can leave the seabed? Oh, wow! Marvelous! The treasure must be there. It will finally be ours. Oh no. It's Angry Alien. And he says that we have invaded his planet and he's going to disintegrate us. We're doomed. Now that is the real treasure chest. And Angry Alien was only trying to help us. He is just the nicest. Oh, how exciting! Quick, open it! But these are lots and lots of treasure maps.
Maps! Alien map?
Hooray for pirates and hooray for the best of treasures continuing the game. Bye-bye, see you next time.
Oh my. A pirate flag? Our friends seem different. They have a telescope. Pocoyo has an eye patch.
A map!
And they have a map. Oh, I see. They're pirates.
Treasure chest!
They're pirates looking for a treasure chest. Oh, they're piranhas. Be careful, Pirate Pocoyo. Pocoyo's Fairy Tales. Hello, Pocoyo. What's that?
Story!
Ah, it looks like Pocoyo has a story for you.
Once upon a time, there was a dinosaur who wanted to go to an island. He took a ship. But then, the ship started to sink. So he took a boat. But then the boat started to sink. So he started to swim. When he got to the island, he phoned his friend, the ant. He asked the ant to come to the island too. So the ant took a ship. But the ship started to sink. So the ant took a boat. But the boat started to sink.
So the ant started to swim. When the ant got to the island, they made a lovely sandcastle and had lots of fun. The end. Our pirates are still looking for the treasure. I think Pato sees something. Can you tell Pocoyo what Pato saw?
The treasure chest!
He saw the treasure chest!
Can you tell Pocoyo what Pato used to see the treasure chest?
The telescope!
The telescope!
What do you see, Pocoyo?
Treasure chest!
What is that?
Monster!
The treasure chest is guarded by a monster. How will our pirates ever get the treasure?
Wheel of Colors! Welcome to the show! Today's color is... orange! Everyone look for something orange. Something orange. What can you find? All right, let's see your pictures. An orange tent. An orange flag. An orange block. Good. Keep searching for orange things. A carrot. Yes, it's orange. An orange key. Excellent. And this, do you know what it is?
An orange alien.
An orange alien. Very good. Hooray for orange!
Hooray! The pirates have landed! Oh, the piranhas are coming too! Uh-oh!
Treasure chest!
Oh no! The monster is awake! Run, Pocoyo, run! And the piranhas! Run, Pato, run! Oh dear! Phew! Now open the treasure chest! Oh! Can you tell me what that is? Another treasure hunt! Ahoy, Pocoyo!
We are the great little pirates. We have a map and a telescope. We are the great little pirates. We're sailing the sea with our pirate flag. We are the pirates in search of a treasure chest. We have a map that tells where it is. We are the pirates in search of a treasure chest. Looking through that telescope.
Treasure chest!
We are the pirates in search of a treasure chest. We have a map that tells where it is. We are the pirates in search of a treasure chest. Looking through that telescope.
If you are feeling sad, if you don't want to play, I know something funny. Everything can change. It's really easy when the music plays. Now is the moment you can try and start to dance. All jumping forward and then all jumping back. Now put your hands up, you can try and start to dance. It's time to move your hips and wiggle your feet. Turn around now, you can try and start to dance. All jumping forward and then all jumping back. Now put your hands up, you can try and start to dance. It's time to move your hips. Wiggle your feet, turn around now, you can try and start to dance. The day of your birthday, dancing in the street, in summer holidays, and also Christmas Eve. In the mountains, or on the beach, anywhere in the world, you can try and start to dance. All jumping forward, and then all jumping back. Now put your hands up, you can try and start to dance. It's time to move your hips. Wiggle your feet, turn around now, you can try and start to dance. All jumping forward and then all jumping back. Now put your hands up, you can try and start to dance. It's time to move your hips and wiggle your feet. Turn around now, you can try and start to dance.
Put your hands in the air, move your feet. Jump, jump, jump. Everybody get down. When I count to three, everybody dancing. One, two, three.
All jumping forward and then all jumping back. Now put your hands up, you can try and start to dance. It's time to move your hips and wiggle your feet.
Muckstruck. Hello, Ellie. Making a nice cup of tea? Oh, dear. That won't do. Good morning, Pocoyo. Ah, bath time. Aren't you forgetting something? Yuck! Your water's gone bad too. Hello, Pato. Oh, do be careful. Your water has a rather icky colour, too. Pato? Something must be done about this nasty water straight away. Very good. You should follow the water pipe to the start. The water in this pond simply must be cleaned up. That poor fish. Oh, we should help him. Ha ha ha! done, Nelly. Very good, Pocoyo. You certainly are collecting lots of rubbish. Wonderful, Pato. This pond will be clean in no time. Everyone. But I'm afraid the water is still brown. Done, every one of you. Well done indeed. Ah, what a perfect morning on the nice clean pond. And it's all thanks to all your hard work, guys.
Hello, Pocoyo. What are you doing? Oh, of course we'll wait. Oh, you've made a card, and a very nice one, too. Do any of you know what it's a picture of?
A whale!
Is that card for whale? Wait, is it whale's birthday today? Is whale having a birthday party? Ellie, are you taking a gift to whale's birthday party? A balloon? But how do you wrap it up? Great work, Pocoyo! I wonder if whale will be able to guess what it is.
Pato!
Let's see what Pato is making for whale. What a wonderful cupcake, Pato! Well, whale is going to love her gifts.
To whale!
Oh dear, that sounded like a balloon popping. Oh dear. Well, at least we still have the card and the cupcake. What a lovely fish. Pato, I think you've lost something. Your cake. Something tells me that fish gobbled it. At least you still have Pocoyo's wonderful card. Yes, there's whale.
Happy birthday, whale.
It's been quite a trip, whale. And everyone made lovely gifts for you. Ellie was going to give you a wonderful balloon. But unfortunately, it popped along the way. And Pato made you a beautiful cupcake. But unfortunately, a little fish ate it up. Luckily, there's still another gift. Pocoyo made you a wonderful birthday card. Oh no! The water spoiled the lovely card Pocoyo made. Oh dear! No balloon, no cake, and no card. Thank you. whale is happy, even if you haven't brought a card or a cake or a balloon. Can any of you tell Pocoyo, Pato and Ellie what, or rather who, they have brought to whale's party?
They brought themselves!
Yes! Pocoyo, Pato and Ellie are here! Hooray for the best gift of all! Friends! And hooray for Pocoyo! See you soon! Bye-bye!
Bye-bye!
Pocoyo?
Hello!
Did you see that? Do you know what that was? Can any of you tell Pocoyo what that is?
It's an old tire!
That's right! It's an old tire someone has thrown away. What's this? A broken alarm clock. What are you going to do with that? Oh, I see. You're throwing it away. Well, why not?
More!
More? Seems as if Sleepy Bird has some rubbish to get rid of as well. Well, looks like everyone is getting in on the act. Cleaning up can be fun. And it's certainly a nice feeling to be rid of all that junk. What's this? Caterpillar. Oh dear, I'm afraid that your doorstep has got a little messy. Pato, you've just pushed the rubbish into the sea. Eggs smell good, do they, Fred? I know, Fred. No one likes rubbish in their eggs. How will you ever get rid of all that junk? Rubbish. I agree, Pocoyo. I certainly don't like it when rubbish falls from the sky onto my blocks. Would any of you like to have a pile of rubbish land in your play area?
No!
What are you doing, Pocoyo? Oh, I see. You've decided to follow the rubbish to find out where it goes. Good plan. It's going in a circle because everyone keeps throwing it onto someone else. Throwing the rubbish around doesn't seem to help, does it? But what can we do? I think Pocoyo has found a way to solve the problem. Solution. Instead of simply throwing the rubbish away, you've worked out how to put it to good use. Hooray for Pocoyo! Hooray for teamwork! Bye-bye! See you soon!
Little fish just waved at me. I will leave you be. I won't catch you, little fish. 8 and 9 and 10, happy swimming in the sea. One and two and three, walking on my foot so free. 4 and 5 and 6, a little ant just waved at me. I will leave you be. You go 8 and 9 and 10. Little ants, I love you so. Some fun, if the spider wants to come, 8 and 9 and 10, we'll have a great time.
holidays. Hello, Pocoyo. It's good to see you.
Hi.
Where have you been these past weeks? Oh, I see. You've been on holidays. I bet you can't wait to tell your friends all about it. And here's Pato, also back from holidays too. How nice. You and Pocoyo will have plenty to talk about. And so will you, Ellie. Holidays are over for everyone. Time for a reunion. Home at last. Well, it's good to be together again. Ah, Ellie, very nice. And Sleepy Bird too. Well now, let's hear what you each did on your holidays. Who wants to start? Pato, perhaps? Oh, a trip to the beach. And you built a sandcastle there. Then you went fishing. What's that? The fish was bigger than that? Still not big enough? Now? Tremendous. Ah, you had some fun in the snow, Ellie. Let's hear all about it. You met some new friends. And you built a big snowman together. My, that is big. And you practiced jumps with your snowboard. How cool is that? What's that? The jump was higher? This high? You jumped so far, you even had time to read and do some yoga and even have a tea party. Why, that's unbelievable. And it looks like Pocoyo and Pato might agree with me. Okay, okay, Ellie. Let's hear your story, Pocoyo. You went flying to outer space. You flew past some amazing planets. A lettuce planet? Sounds very healthy. And a strawberry planet? Delicious. Until you got to a planet made of cake and giant candy? Are you quite sure, Pocoyo?
Yes, sir.
You seem to have had a lot of fun there, Pocoyo. And then you ate the whole planet?
Yes!
Well, did that really happen? I'm not sure the others buy your tale, Pocoyo. What about your holidays, Sleepy Bird? What did you do? That just might be the most wonderful holidays of all of them.
Mine best.
Hold on now. Must you all argue about your holidays? After all, it's fun to share our holiday stories with our friends. Even if maybe some parts of the stories aren't exactly how things happened.
No!
Come on now, Pocoyo. And really, the best part is that you're all here having fun together again.
Yay!
Off you go. Time for play.
Let's play!
And no more tall tales.
Bye!
Good. Bye-bye now.
Pocoyo?
Ah.
Hi, Ellie. Hola, Pato. What's that sound? Oh, I see. Pato has set his alarm. That's odd. Packing? Where are you off to, Pato? You're going to visit your friends, Fred and Whale, underwater. What fun! Good idea. You'll need those where you're going. You're wondering what Pato is up to, right? Can any of you tell Pocoyo and Ellie where Pato is going?
To visit Whale and Octopus.
He's going underwater.
Bye, Pato. Have fun! Playing with friends underwater. What could be more fun? What's this? A ball! Great! You're going to play catch! Ow. It's hard to play catch underwater. Oh, of your toys are floating away. What are you going to play with? Ah, your trumpet. Now this should be fun. Oh, dear. Apparently, trumpets and water don't mix. Ah, now here's something you can enjoy. A comic book. Oh, dear, it's ruined. Pato? Oh, dear, being underwater even puts a damper on your tantrum. I'm afraid Pato isn't having as much fun as he expected to. Ah, nothing like a nice meal to cheer you up, right, Peppa? Whoa! That certainly is an interesting dish. Seaweed spaghetti, is it? Peppa wants to know if you'd like to eat some. No, me? No. Oh, no, no, no. I ate earlier. I think you'll have to tuck in, Pato. Good work, Pato. Oh, dear, you're not leaving, are you, Pato? Is it because none of your toys worked? And you don't like the food here? I suppose you're missing home. Looks like Whale is going to give you a ride before you leave, just to show you how much fun being underwater can be. Wow! Whee! This is kind of fun, isn't it? There's something else Whale would like to show you before you go, Pato. A bubble. Look at that. You can play ball in there, just like at home. This? Sponges. A sponge trampoline. What fun! It looks as if Pato is having a really great time. What do you think? Does Pato like it underwater after all? What's this? A giant shell? What's inside?
Bear!
It's Pocoyo and Ellie! Hooray for getting used to new things! And hooray for fishy friends! Bye-bye! See you soon!
Pocoyo and Lula are going to the beach today. Hello, Pocoyo. Hello, Lula, too. Right, a day at the beach. They have a picnic lunch and a beach umbrella and... Pocoyo, where are you going? That's not the way to the beach. Ah, good idea, Pocoyo. A ball, a round, orange, little ball. What a good thing to take with us.
Round.
Yes, round, like a circle. Very good, Pocoyo. Well, I'm sure Lula will love to play fetch with it in the sand. Now, we'd better get... Pocoyo, the beach is, not that way either. Oh, dear. There you are. Now, where is that ball? Do you see it, Pocoyo? Which one is it? Can any of you tell Pocoyo which one is his ball?
The round one.
It's round.
Round.
That's right, Pocoyo. Your ball is round. Now we can go to the beach. Our friend Pato seems to be having fun. Very nice, Pato. But, oh, look out! Phew, that was close, wasn't it, Pato? Uh-oh, here comes Lula. Oh, poor Pato. And after he worked so hard. Pato, I think Pocoyo's ball is somewhere in here. Can you help?
Round.
Yes, Pato's right. Everything here seems to be round. But wasn't there something else about your ball, Pocoyo? Can any of you tell Pocoyo which one is his ball? Oh, Lula sees it too. Oh, no, not again. Sorry about that, Pato. Oh, juggling! How clever! Look out! Oh, dear. Hello, Ellie.
Ellie!
Oh, this looks a bit more difficult, doesn't it? Perhaps you should tell Ellie what your ball looks like.
Rounds. Orange.
No, that's not it. What else did we say about the ball? It's round, it's orange, and... Can any of you help Pocoyo work out which one it is?
It's little!
Little!
Good thinking. So... Now that you've got your ball, do you think we can finally go to the beach? The beach! Oh, I see. sea. Well, I suppose we got here after all. Hooray for Pocoyo! All in all, it's a lovely day for Pocoyo. And for me too, for that matter.
Bye-bye.
Bye! See you soon! Hello, Pocoyo.
Hello.
What shall we play today, Pocoyo? Yes, I see it too, Pocoyo. Something shiny. I'm not sure Pocoyo knows what that is. Can any of you tell Pocoyo what this is?
It's a key.
Exactly, a key. And who knows what surprises it might unlock. How exciting. Yes, and you know, if I didn't know better, I'd say that was the kind of key they once used to open old pirates' treasure chests.
Treasure? Treasure!
That's amazing. It looks like... It is a keyhole, Pocoyo.
Treasure?
Give it a try. Well, I don't know about treasure, but I've never seen anything like that before.
Hello. Treasure. Treasure.
Well, there's no treasure here. Sorry for waking you, sleepy bird.
Key. Treasure. Treasure!
Hey, another keyhole! Ooh, I didn't realize we had a basement.
Treasure! Treasure.
Surprised to see us, Pato.
Treasure Pato.
Exciting. Go on, give it a try. Now they're on the bottom of the sea. Well, this looks like it's as far as you can go, doesn't it? I don't believe Look!
Treasure!
You know, I think it just might be. Nothing would surprise me after what I've seen today. Go ahead, Pocoyo. Open it. I wonder what's inside. Sweets? Toys? What could the treasure be? What is it? What's there? Will all of you go and look and tell me what's in the treasure chest?
Lots of keys!
Treasure!
This is the best treasure of all, isn't it? After the fun we've had today. Keep opening doors, asking questions, and exploring your world. That is the key to it all. Hooray for Pocoyo! Bye-bye. See you soon.
Are we there yet? Hello, Ellie. Off to the beach, are you? Ah, just a quiet day by yourself. That sounds very relaxing. Why, look, there's Pato. Ellie, I think Pato wants to go with you. What's that, Pato? You wouldn't mind driving? That's very nice of you. What do you think, Ellie? Pato. Ellie was hoping for a relaxing day today. Ah, yes, much better. More friends, Ellie. One more couldn't hurt, right, Ellie? And off we go, all together. What's the matter, Nina? Oh, of course. Pato, you'd better stop the car. You too, Pocoyo. Oh, great. Just what we needed. Which way to the beach?
Look at that. Up there.
Ah, very good, Ellie. Maybe he can tell us how to get there. But we're back at the same place again. Oh, no, not again. Sun begin. Well, Ellie, there's nothing like sharing this marvelous sunset with your friends, is there? Even if it was a little hard to get to the beach. Goodbye, everyone. Hello, Potto. Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
Oh, the postman. And he's got a postcard. I wonder who it's from. It's Ellie. She's at the beach. What fun. It would be nice to go to the beach.
I make.
You'll make a beach, Pocoyo? Hmm. Well, you'll need a spade.
Spade.
A bucket.
Bucket.
Sunglasses.
Sunglasses.
And a sandcastle.
Sandcastle.
Okay, let's make a beach.
Professor Otto.
Now, class, pay attention. Professor Pato says, this is a beach. And this is the sun. The sun. At the beach, you use an umbrella to block the sun. It's very nice under the umbrella. Baby Bird, it's your turn. Can you tell Baby Bird what that is?
Umbrella!
It's an umbrella.
Hmm.
Tell us.
It looks as if the angry alien has something he wants to say.
Umbrella!
Wonderful. Now we've all learned about the beach. Thank you, Professor Pato.
Lesson approved by Professor Pato.
Ah, it looks like you two are ready for the beach. Can you tell me what that is?
A spade!
That's right, a spade. And what's this?
It's a bucket!
Right, it's a bucket. But that's not all you need, boys. Can you tell me what those are?
Sunglasses!
Fantastic! You're ready for the beach. The postman again. Ah, another postcard. Ellie has a very big sandcastle. Hmm. how are you going to make a sand castle?
I find.
Animals, dot to dot.
Hello, Pocoyo. Oh, I see. You're concentrating on that picture. Do you know what it is? Why don't we connect the dots to finish the drawing? How about now, Pocoyo? Do you know what animal it is? No? Let's connect more dots. Now do you know what animal it is, Pocoyo? Can you tell Pocoyo what it is?
A monkey!
A monkey!
Monkey!
A monkey! Right!
Hoop, 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 hoop!
Ah, you found some sand. And what a beautiful sand castle.
Sand castle!
Ellie's back. Can you tell Ellie what Pocoyo and Pato did? What's this? Shells! Seashells! Wonderful! So long! See you soon!
Let's go to the beach. Let's play in the sun with our sunglasses on. Let's open the umbrella and play with the spade and the bucket. Let's make a sandcastle, yeah.
Beach! Sunglasses! Umbrella! Spade! Bucket! Sandcastle!
Let's go to the beach. Let's play in the sun with our sunglasses on. Let's open the umbrella and play with the spade and the bucket, yeah.